Hello guys, this video aims to give you insight on how you can quickly remove this risky software and any risky software from your Mac. This video is going to be separated into two parts. First one is automatic removal, and then I'm going to guide you through manual removal steps and how you can remove it from your browsers as well. Before we begin watching the video and before I take you through the steps, I want you to know that you should always use trustworthy sources when you follow instructions and make sure that these are real people, because many video makers and websites may only be after your money. So let's get on with the video, shall we? First off is the automatic removal. For the automatic removal, we're going to be using the help of a powerful anti-malware software for Mac. You're going to open the video and you're going to click on the description below. It has a link. You have to click that link, guys. And this link is going to take you through your tailor-made removal article. There you will find a download button which you should click. It's going to take you to the download page of this software. The download should begin automatically. When the download is finished, simply open the installer and it will open a pop-up window. When you see this pop-up window, guys, simply click on it, double-click on the icon, and this will run the installer. When the installer has been ran on your computer, you have to click on open, and then simply what you have to do is follow the steps. Click on continue, and then click on I accept and consent, and then install. And that's it, easy as that. It's gonna install the software, and when it installs this program on your computer, it's gonna run automatically. And basically that's it for the installation of this software. It's super easy, and when it's done, you have to click on start scan now to begin any scans. And this software is gonna detect any unwanted software. It could take some time, but it's for good, because it's scanning your Mac's file system and it's looking for every threat. And when it's done, you gotta click on next and click on select all objects and proceed. For this video, I'm just clicked on ignore, just to show you that it removes malware, and then you can select which unwanted software you want to specifically remediate. And as you can see here, it says issues remediated, and then you click on finish, and that's it, guys. You're done. That's how you work with this program, and it can help you to remove this software automatically. For the manual removal process, I'm gonna take you through how you can remove this software from the applications. First, you click on go, and then you go to applications, and then you're gonna find any apps, and then you're gonna drag them to your bin. That's it. Any apps that are suspicious should go this way. If they don't go, you can close them as a process by clicking on go and clicking on utilities, and then clicking on activity monitor. This will open your activities, and you can see that some programs have processes that are unfamiliar and suspicious. Your job is to look for those processes, and when you find them, simply you have to mark them with your mouse and click on force quit process. That's easy as that, guys. You can see, mark with your mouse and click on force quit, and basically that's how it's done. So your next job is to remove this nasty software from your browsers. To do that, for Google Chrome, you're gonna open Chrome and you're gonna type in the address bar chrome://settings/clear-browser-data, and it's gonna open the clear browser data on Chrome. And when it does that, you're gonna go to all time, you're gonna select all time, and you're gonna select everything except passwords. Do not tick passwords, and then click on clear data. And basically that will clear any cookies, any trackers that may be tracking you, any browser hijackers, and so on. Then you're gonna remove any extensions by clicking on more tools and extensions. This will open the extensions, and you can select any extensions that are suspicious and remove them by clicking on remove. And it is easy as that to clean Google Chrome. The next browser I'm gonna show you is Safari browser. You're gonna open Safari, and you're gonna swipe on the Safari drop-down menu, and you're gonna click on Safari, and then we're gonna click on preferences, and then you see the home page, and you see that here it's changed. You're gonna set it to the current page, or set it to any page you would like it to be. Then you click on search, and this will allow you to change your search back to your default search, and then click on extensions and click on uninstall on any extension that you find unfamiliar or suspicious. It's gonna take you to the applications where you can once again drag it to your bin. And that's how you clean up Safari, basically. Oh yeah, it's gonna ask you to type password, which is an administrative action, and that's it. For Mozilla Firefox, you're gonna open Firefox and you're gonna go to the top right corner, click on the drop down menu and click on add-ons. This is gonna open the Firefox add-ons. You're gonna see there some suspicious extensions. You simply can disable them, and then you can remove them by clicking on the three dots and remove. It's as easy as that, and this is how you get rid of suspicious extensions that show ads. Then you're gonna go and refresh Firefox by typing about double dot support and hitting enter. This will open the support window, and then you will locate a button called refresh Firefox, which you have to click, and then you have to click on refresh Firefox again, and this is gonna refresh Firefox. As you can see here, it takes a bit of time to do, and when it's done, Firefox will open a window and say success, or say you're running the latest version of Firefox like it's shown here. And basically that's it. You say congratulations and so on, and that's it for Firefox, basically, guys. The next browser I'm gonna take you through is Microsoft Edge. You're gonna do is open Edge browser, and just like Chrome, you're gonna type Edge /, and then /, settings, and then / clear browser data, which is gonna open a very similar menu because Edge is based on Chrome, and then you're gonna click on all time, and you're gonna tick everything, of course, except passwords, because if you've saved any passwords, they're gonna be gone if you tick it. And then you're gonna click on clear now, and basically that takes care of Edge. Next up is Opera. For Opera browser, it's also based on Chromium, so you're gonna open Opera, and then you're gonna go to the address bar, and then you're gonna click on Opera. You're gonna type Opera settings, and then clear browser data. It's gonna open a very similar to Edge and Chrome menu, in which you're gonna basically select at first advanced, and then select all time. After that, tick on absolutely everything, and then clear data. Remember, guys, don't tick passwords. It's not a good idea unless you don't care. And basically that's it, guys. Thank you for watching. Subscribe if you like this video, hit the like button, and comment. Make sure to respond very fast, so ask us any questions you'd like. Thank you for watching, guys.